everybody. Josh here with another FAQ about care and maintenance of your wax chain. This is a question we've been getting a ton of from people, both for hot wax and for drip wax. And I think, you know, because we do this all day, every day, we forget that you guys don't know all the little tips and tricks. So I'm going to try to remember as many as I can, but I'm sure I'm going to forget something. So please be sure to ask your questions in the comments to help us with future videos on topics like this. So you're waxing your chain now. This is my personal bike, the one I commute to work on. It has a wax chain. In this case, it's a Hot Wax X chain that I've been running for, well, this chain is 3 years old. Hot Wax X is pretty amazing. I'm getting about 800 to 900 kilometers per application out of, but most excitingly, I have this funny little chain checker here, and I think this is so cool. 3 year old, this is probably 9,000, maybe 10,000 kilometers on this chain, and let's check it out. I drop my thing in there, and look at that. Doesn't even register wear. It is still at new on that. One of the huge benefits of wax, you know, you're a little bit of work up front to get the chain stripped and cleaned, but really they do just last forever. Quiet, fast, efficient. I'm not telling you anything you don't already know, but we now have our wax chain on the bike. We need to wipe it down, do some maintenance. Maybe we've just ridden in the rain or done a dusty gravel ride. What are my options? And so a couple of things. We talk a lot about these guys, the microfiber towel, or as we always abbreviate internally, the MF towel, which makes me think of Samuel L. Jackson. You don't need no MF towels on the plane. Why is a microfiber towel important? Well, if you look at the cross section of an individual microfiber, it looks something like this, which is crazy because this thing is a fraction the diameter of a human hair, and it looks like that. Like, that's hard to get your head around. Each one of those little corners, though, is a gripping, wiping surface, right? So this towel has hundreds, if not thousands of times the number of wiping edges of something like a terry cloth towel or a cotton towel or a paper towel. And if you buy a high quality microfiber towel, they also are fully loop knit through so that there is zero linting. And that is why, you know, we don't make these microfiber towels. We buy them from the best supplier that we've been able to find. They are absolutely zero lint. You know, you don't want fibers. This is why you don't use a paper towel, right? You get those kind of cardboardy, like wood pulp fibers can actually get down in your chain. That's not helping with your lubrication. So wipe with a microfiber towel. And the way that I recommend to do it is, you know, you can take a light degreaser, something like the SILCA biodegreaser, dampen the towel a little bit, and you want to just wrap it around the chain at the bottom and backpedal through. And Michelle will have to quiet that down because I'm sure my microphone picked that up something terrible. But spray on here, grab it around the bottom, run it through a couple of times. That's going to get off any of that surface kind of contamination, road grit stuff that we talk about. You know, if you're using super secret drip lube, a lot of the times, you know, every 3-4 rides, you know, maybe there's just a little bit of road dust on there. Wipe it down lightly. The degreaser will not attack the wax because remember, all the SILCA products are designed to be friendly to wax. So it'll take oils, it'll take road grit, it'll take dirt. The wax stays in place. And then that allows you to top off with the super secret. We talk a lot about where and how to apply. And the answer is that you want to cross chain, as I've got here, not fully, but you want a big ring, you know, maybe second or third cog down from the top. And what that's doing is the chain, because your cogs and rings are straight, and when the chain has to angle to articulate between them, you end up opening a little triangle of gap in the chain as it goes from straight this way to straight on the cog. And so what you want to do is cross chain it a little bit, get your bottle, and you want to be applying the drip right here on top of the roller as you back pedal, drop, one drop per roller. The other thing we've seen in the comments, people saying that the super secret can be too thin and that it runs straight off. If you're seeing something like that, you have not shaken it well enough. You know, give it a really good shake every single time that you use it. And if it's sat for a month or so, you know, you might have to shake it for 20, 30 seconds. just to be sure to get it nice and kind of homogenized in there. And then it should come out as you see in our picture. Well, here, I'll have Michelle put a picture up. This one, it should look like that. Little kind of like hemispheres of lube sitting on top. And then you can also use your finger to kind of push and kind of wet that down into the metal surface. But the other real advantage of doing it up here, you've got this little triangle of space that opens as the chain changes lateral angles, but then you go from straight to articulated as it takes on this cog, and then it straightens, then it articulates onto the pulley, then it straightens again, then it articulates again, then it straightens again. I mean, a whole lot happens in this little short space. So you are doing the maximum working of the lubricant to get it down into the chain. And we have tested, I mean, every possible way, and absolutely without a doubt, the most effective place to lubricate the chain right there on the top. That's important. So if you're super secret, you're doing a simple wipe down, wipe with this guy. Maybe you want to use a Silca gear wipe. These also work great. They play very well with wax. They're non-linting and, you know, kind of the same thing. Pull it out. You want to grab it at the bottom of the chain here and just backpedal through a number of times. I tend to do, you know, from a kind of finger perspective, I kind of do finger pressure top and bottom for a couple revolutions, and then maybe finger pressure on the side for a couple of revolutions, just to make sure we're getting all four sides of the chain cleaned and wiped down. At that point, you can do your super secret drip. Your other option, like once you want to reset your wax chain, if you're using super secret drip, you can use a fancy little kettle like this one. This one I got off Amazon. I've got a link right here below. It's from, I think, Greater Goods. It's a fun Japanese style pour over little coffee pot, but this one actually has an induction heater. You know, these are not that expensive. I think it was 40 or 50 bucks. What I love about this is that you can boil your water, and you, what you want to do is you want to pour right here onto the front of the chain as you pedal forward. And the idea is that you're pouring hot water here, and it's going to run down this way. So you're heating the chain and heating the wax. You're allowing the water to run through, and as it gets to the bottom, it's going to be dripping off. And it's pretty cool. You will sort of rain the old wax and dirt, again, right here, and pedal forward, not backwards, as you to come through. And you can catch with a paper towel or something on the ground right under here. You will just capture all of that used wax as well as any dirt or contamination that happened to get in here. This is one we're going to cut some B-roll outside to kind of show you what that looks like. One of the things you can't see in here is to get the sound under control. I'm actually standing on some really pretty thick, fluffy shag carpeting that just keeps it from being echoey. So I am not going to pour boiling water and melt wax onto my my fancy shag carpet. You shouldn't either. You'll get in trouble for that. Trust me, I've been there. Your other option is to use your quick link, take the chain off, and throw it into your Instant Pot or your crock pot. I've talked about it before. One of the things I love about the Instant Pot is that you've got the removable liner. You can see I've got my wax in here. Oh, look, I've got a water boiling pot too. Once you own the Instant Pot, these liners I think are like $24, $25. What I do personally at home, I've got two liners, put that in, put it on saute, get the water boiling, or don't have to, throw the chain in, let it boil for 5 or 10 minutes. All the wax comes off, floats to the top. Pull the chain out, swap your pots, throw it in, hit go. The beauty of the wax and the water is that they do not like each other at all. And so the wet chain can go in. Once the wax is up to temperature, the water is going to boil off. And actually, the lack of air bubbles or visible bubbles at the top from the water escaping is a good indicator that your waxing is done. And so two liners, one pot, super fast. It's probably 10 minutes per cycle. You don't even have to be in the same room as it does it. Pull it out, as we've shown you in previous videos, put it back on, and you are ready to go. So I think I've covered it. If there's anything I've missed, any questions you guys have, please, like I said, put them in the comments below. These videos are all, they're really for you, right? We're here to answer the questions that you've had. Yeah, I'll give you a link to the Instant Pot, a link to my clever little dripper. Thanks for watching.